Testing, testing, 1, 2. If we could take a seat, please. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2016 Earl Warren Cup. Will you please stand for the posting of our colors by the Bakersfield High School Air Force Junior ROTC and remain standing for the flag salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Before I start my welcome, I have been told for some reason we got to make sure the aisles are clear. Make sure your feet are not in the aisles. I have no idea what's going on, but the aisles need to be clear. Once again, welcome to one of the most unique academic competitions you'll find in the state of California. As you know, there is usually a bit of a buzz about the razzmatazz of the opening and what's going to happen. It wasn't that long ago that I was sitting on a chair about 20 feet above my head and flew into the Earl Warren Cup. About 10 months ago, our co-hosts for tonight, Mr. Adams and Mr. Rainier, were sitting and mentioning some possibilities and throwing things by me. They started with shooting the principal through a cannon. I said no. Talked about elephants. And I said no. Giraffes, no. Fireworks were brought up, and I said definitely no. Finally, I said, gentlemen, two words, low key. there's a new superintendent in the current high school district, my boss, and I would like to keep my job for at least 4 more years until I retire. Some new board members who don't know me that well yet. And I said, the most flamboyant thing I want to see tonight is this Disney tie with Mickey Mouse. So, without further ado, I'd like to introduce our co-host for tonight. Two words, low key, Mr. Kevin Rainier and Mr. Jeremy Adams.
We made it. We made it.
Wow.
There are a lot of people here. More than I was expecting. I only had two poppers. Welcome to the 2016 Earl Warren Cup. My name is Jeremy Adams.
And I'm Kevin Rainier.
And we are your hosts for this evening. We would like to begin tonight, as we always begin, with a reading of the preamble. New Speaker of the House, Mr. Paul Ryan.
Hello, Bakersfield High School Drillers. I'm Speaker Paul Ryan. I want to thank you for understanding the importance of our history and our system of government and for participating in the Earl Warren Cup. I'll start, as we always do, by stating the preamble to the Constitution. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America. I want to wish you all the best of luck, and go Drillers.
We gather this evening to do more than ask questions and questions about American government. Beyond the famous people, and there are many, and the glitz and glamour, and there will be a lot, let us remember what the Earl Warren Cup is really all about. It's about remembering what so often eludes us. Let us, for the next 90 minutes, remember that we are a nation based not on paper and parchment, but on a passion for the political principles of human justice. We are a people who fight and sacrifice to reconcile the realities of our world with our highest hopes of what we want it to be. We are a people who toil in trenches. We are a people who go to beaches and raise flags. We are a people aspiring for all children to reach their dreams, regardless of the circumstance of their birth. We are a people who run into burning buildings and not out of them. And in the midst of all this remembering, perhaps we will find the inspiration to look forward. The Earl Warren Cup is not just a reminder of what America is, my friends. Look on this stage and look around you, and tonight, you will remember and see what America will be. Let the needle of our American compass point forward towards a future of genuine liberty and genuine justice. The mantle of freedom is sacred. Now, let us find out who will assume it.
I'm proud to be your friend.
Thank you, Mr. Rainier.
I'm proud to be your friend. That was amazing. That was truly amazing.
I really appreciate it. Your hair looks great.
And we both know that's as important to me as that speech was to you. And I'm using a new product. The plugs are setting in beautifully. I'm very happy with it. Very happy.
Is that
something? Looks good, right?
Now, how old are you? I mean, are you
52. I'm in my 50s. My goal is to have my 50s last as long as my 40s.
Okay. That's good. Because I got to tell you, I'm not 40 yet, so I don't really...
Yeah, I know, but you...
I don't really know how that would work. So
you look it.
Wow. You know, I got to say, Mr. Reese is going to yell at us tomorrow, but I thought that was modest.
Oh, humble. Yeah,
humble.
How do your students carry you in like a pharaoh throwing tokens to the people in the audience? Yeah, that was modest.
I got to tell you, Mr. Reese didn't come from the ceiling.
That is true. Nowhere in sight.
No.
And we did not, much to the surprise of, I think, a lot of people sitting here.
No, we didn't. We didn't. So, you know, we don't have to do a big song and dance routine. Let's just get started.
Minimal.
Okay.
Wait a minute. I that was interesting what you said right there.
What?
Well, you just said something, but we've never done a song and dance routine before, Mr. Adams.
Oh,
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy.
Then a series of doors in my face, and then suddenly
Cause like, I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the equations talking, cause I'm feeling symmetry.
But tonight, I see your face, and it's nothing like I've ever known before. Welcome to Earl Warren Cup. Welcome to Earl Warren Cup. I've never met someone who asked them just like me. Jinx! Jinx again! Our mental situation can have no one explanation. Or warn you to be.
Say goodbye
to the pain of the past. Apathetic anymore. Welcome to Earl Warren Cup. Welcome to Earl Warren Cup.
Everyone as much as they deserve to be thanked, I would never get to the actual competition this evening. I just hope everyone who has contributed knows how much I appreciate them. I asked so many people to come here tonight, so a profound and hearty thanks to everyone sitting here this evening. That said, without our extraordinary sponsors, none of this would be possible. Thank you to longtime sponsors Grimway Farms, the law firm of Klein & Attali, the CPA firm of Keith Lee Maxwell and Anton Giovanni, and also Jim Burke Ford. Also to a BHS Rock, Salties. A number of individuals have contributed as well. Thank you to Jeff Green, David Duquette, and Bernard Barman. Big, big thank you to Chevron and all of my friends there, Abby and Ariel LaFont, Salters, really came through and clearly understand that authentic achievement stands at the crossroads of technology and imagination and passion. The Gate Parent Club is always supportive and appreciated. Without David Reese and Ann 11 and Pam Rainier, so many details, and especially former student Andrew Deem for running the website. Kevin McCarthy's office, especially George Kareem, who has been working on this for almost a year. He's probably watching from DC right now. Thank you, George, for everything. A big shout out to our awesome superintendent, Brian Schaefer. Thank you for coming. I hope to see you at the gym. He's in good shape. I see him at the gym. I really do. Okay. Matt and Randy, you are truly indispensable. Thank you to my wonderful wife, Jennifer, Tony, who are so supportive and what can I say about the man to my right? He refused getting, and yet look what he just cup. While neither of us would be heading to Broadway anytime soon, you always do anything for you. There are not enough thank yous in the universe, my friend.
Thank you.
And it features three. In the first three rounds, the questions correctly. Rainier. Rounds, it will be the first from a different bowl containing harder questions. The moves rather quickly once we get started. We have three judges here in case there are questions that are close. Our judges are Larry Adams, former BHS, and my dad. Thank you. Cool. On a serious note, not yell out and whisper them, say them in your mind. The and voices carry. So please, please, answers out loud. Security, we'll be monitoring the crowd. So please behave yourself.
For these. Okay. Sure. All right. Well, hold on a second. R2, hang on. Just a second. I got a question for you. Come here. Come over here close. R2, who's Ray's father? Oh. See, it makes complete sense now that you say it like that. Thank you. Thank you, R2.
Give it up for R2, everybody. Thank you. Okay. End of the contestant.
They're right there.
Ladies and gentlemen, now that we have the questions, I think we're ready to bring on the contestants. What do you say? So let us bring them in. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our number one seed. If if she's making her way up there. Right now, Miss Madeline.
She's been accepted to Georgetown, and she has a twin sister named Noelle. Give it up for Madeline. Number two is Miss Hannah Chang. She is interested in going to BC, and she can fold a t-shirt in 2 seconds. Good luck, Hannah.
Wow. 2 seconds.
Okay. Our third contestant is Mr. Jacob Lee. He hopes to go to UCLA, and he wants to in the Pacific Ocean with whales and squid.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
Our next contestant is Mr. Nathan Solin. He's probably going to be going to Cal Poly Slow, and he can sing Disney songs in Norwegian, and he really can, by the way. Next is Mr. Mikey Brust. He's going to go to Weber State on a debate scholarship, and he thinks Joe Biden is his father. Next is Mr. Knox Borges, a.k.a. Star-Lord. He's going to Cal Poly Slow as well, and he looks good, this good all the time. I mean, Christopher Borges is your dad, right? Next is Miss Christina McKenna. She will attend BC and then transfer who knows where, and she speaks fluent Lithuanian. Next is Felix Cooper Adamo. He's going to go to college and do track and field, and Derek Van Horn is his spirit animal. Next is Mr. Jacob R. Pearson, who will be going to the Air Force, and he is a fourth generation Air Force. Next is Miss Kat Piper. She is interested in attending UCLA or the University of Nebraska, and she can tap dance. Okay.
There we go. Thank you.
Next is Mr. Jacob Mata. He wants to go to the University of Washington, and he has an unhealthy monomaniacal obsession with Bernie Sanders. He wants everyone to feel the burn. Next is Ms. Kristen Dakers, who's going to UCLA, and she has only been a U.S. citizen for 3 months. Next is Emma Doty, and she is maybe going, maybe, to San Diego State University, and she likes to dress like Cassidy Grimsley. Next is Mr. Tim Rossi. He hopes to get accepted into West Point, and he's running for Jedi Council member.
Ooh.
Our 15th seat is Mr. Adrian Abarca. He's going to study engineering at UC Irvine, and he is looking forward to Kanye 2020. Next is Ms. Noelle Pardo. She's been accepted at UT Austin, and she has a twin sister named Madeline. Our number 17 seat is Mr. Bo Bukakis. He wants to go to Cal Poly, and he went to Taco Bell every day his junior year. Mr. Wilmot, this is Bo. It's a joke, I guess, I don't know. Next, Ms. Mackenzie Zimet, who has committed to Cal Poly Slow, and she eats peanut butter on her waffles. Our 19 seed, Miss Bella Gallego. She is going to UCSD, and even if she doesn't win tonight, she gets 5 points on her next AP Calc test, she says.
That is absolutely true.
Good. Our number 20 seed is Miss Cassidy Grimsley. She has been accepted to Baylor University, and she loves to dress like Emma Doty. Okay. Number 21, Miss Natalie. I need some help here.
Natalie Madrigal Palacios.
Thank you. She is going to go to UC Berkeley, and I tried her name. I wanted to give it the respect it deserves. Our 22nd seed, big news here, Miss Maddie Ridley. She wants to attend UCSD, and she says on here, plot twist, I don't want to be an engineer. Number 23. Inside BHS joke there, folks. Mr. Perez. He's going to go to the University of Michigan at Ann Arbor, and he can speak 4 languages.
Wow.
Next is Ms. Bilkis Kulungu, who wants to go to UCLA, and her favorite show is Avatar: The Last Airbender. Whoa. Next is Mr. Braden McCann. He's going to Cal Poly SLO. And if he doesn't win the Earl Warren Cup, he always has college to fall back on. I love your bow tie. Number 26, Mr. Oscar Torres. He also wants to attend UCLA, and he can cook one minute rice in 58 seconds. Next is Mr. Cameron Johnson, and he plans to attend BC and play baseball, and One Direction is his favorite band. I don't know. Next is Mr. Austin Phillips. He's going to go to Brigham Young, and he says he'll be signing autographs later. Our 29 seed, Mr. Nicholas William Charles Barker IV, hopes to attend MIT, and he enjoys reading books on string theory and quantum physics.
Right.
Number 30, Ahalem Ahmed is interested in going to UCLA, and her favorite flavor is potatoes. Listen to this one. Here is Cherie Reyes, sometime. Cherie, here she is. Ladies and gentlemen, Cherie became a naturalized citizen 2 days ago. And finally, last but not least, Miss Samantha Maddox. She plans on going to CSUB, and she met the entire 49ers football team when she was just 10. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for all the contestants now. Let's give it up for them. I wanted our contestants to be here before I broke some bad news. I guess I do need to mention one big failure, and I know a lot of you will be disappointed up on the stage, and I'm sorry. I did not get a question from Hillary Clinton. But there's a very, very, very brief story behind it. She told me she taped a question like I asked her to. The problem was she emailed it. When I told her I received it, she seemed to blame everybody, world leaders, the media, other Democrats, Republicans. She said, "It's out there, Jeremy, go find it." So I went to the one person who probably intercepted it. Honestly, Putin pretty much ignored me the whole time. He waved his hand and said, "I do not care about this Earl Warren Cup thing. It is probably CIA anyhow. Nothing in this life is free." Which got me thinking, who likes free stuff? Maybe they could help me out. But, he wasn't helpful. He just said, "Whatever your problem is, blame it on a billionaire." Trump listened as I told him I was looking for Hillary's question, but then he suddenly said I was a stupid, ugly, nobody loser with low energy. Clearly, he'd been talking to Mr. Rainier. So I went back to Hillary. She said maybe one of her opponents stole the question. The problem was, I went to ask them, but I couldn't remember any of their names. Finally, last but not least, even Marco Rubio was unhelpful. I spent the whole time trying to convince him that, yes, you are old enough to be president. With that in mind, let us begin. Maddie, we will begin with you. What term was used in the 1996 presidential race to describe suburban women who spend significant time transporting their children to sporting events?
Soccer moms?
Correct, 1-0. Samantha, in which amendment is the right to petition the government guaranteed?
I do not know.
For the steal?
The first.
Correct, 2-0. Picture question 37. In this picture, what is Lyndon Johnson doing aboard Air Force One?
He is being sworn into office.
Correct for the victory. Next, can we have Noelle and Beau? Noelle, we'll start with you. How many justices has President Obama appointed to the Supreme Court?
Three.
Incorrect. For the steal, Beau.
Two.
Correct. 1-0. Okay. Beau, please translate this Latin phrase, vox populi, vox Dei.
I'll pass.
Okay. For the steal.
I don't know.
The voice of the people is the voice of God. Noel, video question two. This is for you.
Bakersfield High School, I am President George W. Bush. The United States was fortunate to be represented around the world by two remarkable secretaries of state during my administration. Name one.
Powell.
Correct. 1-1. Bo, we go to you. What part of the U.S. Constitution ends with the words, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America? I need an answer.
The preamble.
Correct. Noel, we go to you. Who has the responsibility of counting electoral votes when the Electoral College meets?
The VP.
Correct. Video question number three for Beau, please.
Hello, Bakersfield High School. I'm President George W. Bush. When I was inaugurated, I took the oath of office in Washington, D.C. Where did the first George W., President George Washington, take the oath of office?
What city, for clarification?
Washington, D.C.?
Incorrect. Is this for the win? For the steal.
I don't know.
Okay. New York. Noel, the score is 2-2. Which delegate gave a 6-hour speech at the Constitutional Convention arguing for an English-style monarchy? I need an answer.
Jefferson?
Incorrect. For the steal and the win.
Hamilton?
Correct. For the victory. Now let's get Jacob and Bill Keith. Okay. Jacob, we'll begin with you. Okay. Please stay quiet, everybody. Thank you. Gregg versus Georgia was a ruling about which amendment of the Constitution? Gregg versus Georgia.
The fourth.
Incorrect. For the steal, Bill Keys.
Gregg versus Georgia. The eighth?
Correct. 1-0. Bill Keys, at the Constitutional Convention, what was the more common name for the Randolph Plan?
The Randolph Plan? The Virginia Plan?
Correct, 2-0. Okay, can we please have, is Jeff Green here from Grimway Farms? Come on up, Jeff. We're going to have some of our sponsors ask questions throughout the evening. Jeff's son was an Earl Warren Cup winner in 2008. Gets this question. Okay. Please read this to Jacob.
Jacob, which government corporation employs the most people in the federal government?
Military?
Incorrect. For the steal.
And the win.
And the win.
I don't know.
Post office.
Thank you so much.
Bill Keith, we go back to you. This is for the victory. Which founding father is known and respected for his level of disinterestedness?
Disinterestedness.
I need an answer.
Andrew Jackson?
Incorrect. For the steel?
John Adams.
Incorrect. George Washington. Jacob, we go to you. What are the three words in the Constitution used to describe the Senate's responsibility to confirm or deny the president's nominees to courts and the cabinet? I need an answer.
Pass.
For the steal and the victory.
Advise and consent.
Correct, for the victory. Braden and Cooper, come on up. Cooper, we'll begin with you. Who is considered to be the father of the Constitution?
James Madison.
Well, I'm sorry, what was the last name?
Madison.
Madison, correct. Yes, okay.
Is that right? Okay.
Braden, we'll go to you. When a United States Supreme Court justice disagrees with the majority decision of the court, he or she writes what decision?
Dissenting.
Correct, one all. Cooper, what is the minimum number of electoral votes needed to be elected president in the Electoral College?
270.
Correct, 2-1. Mr. McCann, the 1996 Voting Rights Act targeted the lack of African American suffrage in which part of the country?
The South.
Correct, to all. Cooper, what office was John Adams referring to when he called it, quote, the most miserable office ever devised by man?
The executive.
Incorrect, for the steal and the victory.
Can you repeat the question?
What is the office John Adams was referring to when he called it, quote, the most miserable office ever devised by man?
The legislative.
Incorrect, the vice presidency. Ooh. Braden, this goes to you for the victory. Who was the first president to continue Washington's tradition of stepping down after two terms? I need an answer. Incorrect. Cooper for the win.
Please repeat the question.
Yes, who was the first president to continue Washington's tradition of stepping down after two terms?
John Adams.
Incorrect, Thomas Jefferson. Cooper, this goes to you, but it's not for the win, because you started. Which form of primary was ruled unconstitutional but was once used by Washington State?
Blanket primary.
Correct, 3-2. Braden, to stay in it. The United States flag has 13 stripes. What does each stripe represent?
The 13 colonies.
Correct. 3-3. Cooper, what practice was begun by the Massachusetts Governor Elbridge Gerry?
Please repeat the question.
What practice was begun by Massachusetts Governor Elbridge Gerry?
Campaigning.
Incorrect. For the steal and the victory. Say again?
Gerrymandering.
For the victory. Nathan and Nick. Nathan, we'll begin with you. Tell me, quiet down, please. Tell me which amendment the following words come from. Quote, whenever there is a vacancy in the office of the vice president, the president shall nominate a vice president who shall take office upon confirmation by a majority vote of both houses of Congress.
Which amendment that was from?
What was that from?
The 25th Amendment?
Correct, 1-0. Nick, presidential nominees are chosen by the delegates of their party who take their cue from the voting in all the states. But who gets to pick the vice president?
The president. Is that close enough? He said the president.
The president?
No.
You want to go ahead and repeat that?
Yes, absolutely. For this deal, presidential nominees are chosen by the delegates of their party, but who gets to pick the vice president in the nomination process? I need an answer.
Okay. If it's not the president, then I'm going to go with the national party? No?
No. No. Incorrect. The nominee himself. Nathan, we go back to you.
Okay.
Who was the second president of the Senate?
The second president of the Senate?
Yes.
Thomas Jefferson?
Correct. Nick, we go to you. Which amendment begins with the phrase, quote, a well-regulated militia composed of the body of the people? My brother is hopefully listening to this one tonight.
The second.
Correct. Nathan, 2-1, this is for the win. What is the term that describes a president approaching the end of his term after his successor is close to being chosen or has already been chosen?
The lame duck.
Correct, for the victory. Cassidy and Emma, come on up. Emma, we'll begin with you. Dred Scott versus Sanford declared which act of Congress to be unconstitutional?
Which act?
Which act or law?
I don't know.
For the steal.
Jim Crow laws.
Incorrect. The Missouri Compromise. Let's go to video number 5, please.
Okay. Hello, I'm William Shellock, or as Mr. Adams knows me, the smartest man in the world. Today I'm here in Rome, Italy, and from the Coliseum, to ask you guys a question for the Earl Warren Cup. Because last year we didn't have one, so this year I get to ask you. In ancient Rome, what form of government did they have? Good luck, Charles. Okay.
I'll say it again. What form of government did they have in ancient Rome?
A republic?
Correct. Emma, we go to you. In the War Powers Act of 1973, Congress has to give authorization to the president to pull out troops within how many days?
60.
Correct. Cassidy, what is the term that describes censorship that was at the question in the court case of Neer versus Minnesota?
Pass.
For the steal.
I don't remember.
The answer is prior restraint. Picture number 39 for Emma, please. Emma, this is Kevin McCarthy. That's not, I knew you were wishing that was the question. He is one of how many Californians holding a seat in the House of Representatives?
3?
Incorrect. For the steal. What was your answer?
3,
yeah. Incorrect.
51?
Incorrect. 53.
Oh, I was misunderstood the question.
Cassidy, we go to you. In the election of 1800, who tied with Thomas Jefferson for the most electoral votes?
Bird?
Correct. Emma, we go to you. What is the name of the government corporation that once ran the space shuttle program?
NASA?
Correct. Cassidy, this is to you for the win. What is the name of the government agency at the center of a controversy about eavesdropping and the collection of data from law-abiding citizens?
The NSA.
Correct, for the win. Kristen and Natalie. Let's go, Natalie. Right now, could we get our sponsor, Mr. Barry Goldner from the offices of Klein Dean Italy? Come on up. There he is. Where are we going to go to first? will start there.
What is the name of the hotel in Washington, D.C. that was at the center of President Nixon's most famous scandal?
Pass.
I don't know.
Watergate.
Natalie, we'll go to you. Who is the current Secretary of State?
John Kerry.
Correct. 1-0. Kristen, we go to you. On September 11th, 2012, the American diplomat in Libya was murdered. What is the name of the city where this tragedy occurred?
Pass.
For the steal.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes.
Please?
On September 11th, 2012, the American diplomat in Libya was murdered. What is the name of the city where this tragedy occurred?
I don't know.
It's Benghazi. Natalie, we go back to you. Who was Bill Clinton's vice president?
Pass.
Kristen.
Can you repeat the question?
Who was Bill Clinton's vice president?
Was it McCain?
I can't hear you.
McCain?
McCain is incorrect. It's Al Gore. Kristen, we go back to you. Four of the last six presidents held what position before winning election to the White House?
Senate.
Incorrect. For the steal.
Congressional legislative.
Incorrect. It's governor. Natalie, we go to you. Who killed Abraham Lincoln? I need an answer.
Harry?
Incorrect. For the steal. I need an answer.
Pass.
John Wilkes Booth. Kristen, what is the name of the presidential decree which helps officers and agencies of the federal government to manage operations within the government and has the force of law?
Executive order?
Correct. 1-1. Natalie, in 2016, how many elections will be held for seats for the House of Representatives?
Can you repeat the question?
Yeah. Of the 435 seats in the House, how many will have elections in 2016?
2-0.
For the steal.
All of them?
Correct. Kristen, this goes to you for the win. The court case of Morse versus Frederick concerned a banner held up by an Alaskan high school student. What did the banner say?
Bong hits for Jesus.
Bong hits for Jesus. Austin and Michael. Austin and Mikey. Mikey, we will begin with you.
Sure.
What is the name of a veto in which the president does nothing to the bill within 10 days of a congressional adjournment?
Do I answer like Jeopardy? Is it like a what is thing?
No, you just say the answer.
Okay, cool. Pocket veto.
Correct. Austin, which early 19th century American policy said that further efforts by European governments to colonize land or interfere with states in the Americas would be viewed by the United States of America as an act of aggression?
The Big Stick policy?
Incorrect.
The Madisonian deal?
Incorrect. The Monroe Doctrine. Mikey, this was for you. Video 8.
Please be Bernie Sanders.
It's not Bernie Sanders.
Damn.
Oh, just give it away. No? You want to do a different video? Let's try video 7, the one you were going to do a second ago. Yeah, I want to try that one.
My father, George Romney, also ran for president. In what Midwestern state had he served as governor?
Utah?
Incorrect. For the steal.
Kansas?
Incorrect. Michigan. Austin. In a 20th century Supreme Court case, a justice famously said, quote, "I know it when I see it." What was he referring to? I need an answer.
It has escaped me.
For the steal.
Obscenity?
Correct. Michael, for the win,
sure.
List one amendment that has never been incorporated into the states.
The third.
Correct, for the victory. Okay. Knox and Cameron, come on up. Knox, we will begin with you.
All right.
Which state in the 2008 presidential election was the only one to split its electoral votes?
So, can I ask, answer like Jeopardy?
No.
No? Okay, Nebraska.
Okay. 1-0. Cameron, what vote is needed in both chambers of Congress to override a veto of the president?
2/3 vote.
Correct, 1-1. Okay, folks, can we please give it up for Mr. Jeff Salters from Salties? Come on up.
I'm older.
It's not the first time that's happened.
Okay, goes to Knox.
Mr. Knox, which 1974 law gave citizens access to information from the executive branch?
The 1974 Freedom of Information Act.
Correct.
Thank you. Cameron, we'll go to you. What American agency was originally headed by J. Edgar Hoover?
The FBI.
Correct, to all. Can we please go to picture 40? This, who am I talking to?
You're talking to Knox.
I'm talking to Knox.
I'm talking to me.
Talking to you.
I'm talking to you, too.
Talking to you, okay.
All right.
This is Dan Quayle. What position did he hold from 1989 to 1993?
Could you please repeat the question?
What position did he hold from 1989 to 1993?
Was he the Secretary of State?
No. For the steal and the win.
Vice President?
Correct, for the victory. Okay. Maddie and Jacob Mata. Yeah! Okay. Okay, Jacob, we'll start with you.
I'll try not to die.
Take a deep breath. Okay. What is the name of the government program that is a social insurance program providing health
coverage?
Social
Security.
Incorrect. What is the name of the government program that is a social insurance program providing health insurance to people who are age 65 and over?
Medicaid.
Incorrect. Medicare. Maddie, we go to you. What state did Hamilton represent as a delegate at the Constitutional Convention?
New York.
Correct. 1-0. Jacob, we go to you. Which Supreme Court justice famously described his confirmation hearings as a, quote, high-tech lynching?
Clarence Thomas.
Correct. 1-1. Let's go to video question number 18 for Maddie.
Hi, my name is Andrew Green. I won the Earl Warren Cup in 2008. After graduating from BHS, I went to UCLA for undergrad, and now I am a second year in law school at University of San Diego. My question to this contestant is, Which Republican candidate currently running for president was once the CEO of the company Hewlett-Packard? Good luck.
So how about it?
Michael Rubio?
Incorrect.
Carly Fiorina.
Correct. Can I get my great, another workout buddy, can I get Michael George from Kern Schools to come on up here for a second, please? You'll be there tomorrow,
yeah.
Tell him it's for the victory.
Okay.
Jacob, yeah.
Jacob, for the victory, Jacob. Which article of the Constitution is known as the Full Faith and Credit Clause?
Is it Article 1, Section 9?
Incorrect. For the steal or the win? Is it?
The fourth.
For the steal. Very good. That's correct.
Maddie, this goes to you for the win. Okay? For the win. Which member of the House of Representatives rarely votes, gives speeches, and never serves on committee?
Speaker of the House.
Correct. Tim and Bella, come on up. Tim, we start with you. Tim, the constitutionality of most New Deal legislation revolved around the interpretation of which controversial clauses of the Constitution?
Commerce Clause?
Correct, 1-0. Bella, we go to you. What vote is needed? What vote is needed in the Senate to ratify a treaty?
2/3.
Correct. 1-1. Tim, we come back to you. Who launched the longest filibuster in American history?
Strom Thurmond.
Yeah. Bella, it's 2-1. Which 20th century president said, quote, "I am not going to order any troops into anything that can be interpreted as war until Congress directs it"?
Bush.
Incorrect. For the steal and the win.
Can you please repeat the question?
Yes. Which 20th century president said, quote, "I am not going to order troops into anything that can be interpreted as war until Congress directs it"?
Ford.
Incorrect. Eisenhower. Tim, we're back to you for the win. Who was president of the Confederacy during the Civil War?
Davis.
Correct for the win. Al Halam and Jacob, come on up. Jacob, we will begin with you. How old does a person have to be to serve in the Senate?
30 years.
Correct.
Old.
Al Halam. Name one president who has been impeached.
Andrew Jackson.
Incorrect. For the steal. Oh.
Andrew Johnson.
Correct. 2-0. Can we get my friend Abigail Affant to come on up here from Chevron?
Jacob, for the win, who is the Library of Congress building named after?
The Thomas Jefferson.
Incorrect. Alam, for the steal.
Can you repeat the question?
Who is the Library of Congress building named after?
Madison?
Correct.
Ahlam, picture 41. To tie 2-2, yeah. Ahlam, if you look really closely, this is me at last year's State of the Union speech. Which attendees of the event are not allowed to clap?
The Supreme Court justices.
Correct. Yeah. To all, this is not for the victory. Okay. Harry Reid holds which leadership position in the U.S. Senate?
The minority leader.
Correct. Okay, we're gonna go to video 12. This is to stay in it. Video 12.
Hey, Bakersfield High, I'm Chuck Todd, moderator of Meet the Press on NBC. Don't miss an episode ever. Anyway, here is my question for you. What is the term to describe the practice of gerrymandering so that districts have an unequal number of citizens within them? Hint. This has been ruled unconstitutional. Good luck.
I need an answer.
Reapportionment?
Incorrect, it's malapportionment. Yeah. Jacob wins, that's it for the win, yeah. Christina and Oscar coming up. We'll begin with you, Christina. Christina, Hillary Clinton was once a U.S. Senator from which state?
Arkansas?
Incorrect. Oscar, for the steal. I need an answer.
Florida.
New York. Oscar, we'll go to you. Which 20th century president brought back the tradition of delivering the State of the Union as a speech?
Nixon?
Say again?
Richard Nixon.
Incorrect, for the steal.
Wait, repeat the question.
Who brought back the tradition of delivering the State of the Union as a speech?
You said 20th century?
20th century.
Roosevelt.
Incorrect, Woodrow Wilson. To Christina, we go to you. Can we have video number 9? Christina, this is for you.
Oh, sorry. Didn't see you there. Just checking the pulse of the city. My name is Neil. I'm a third-year medical student here in beautiful Chicago, and I also won the Earl Warren Cup back in 2007. All right, drillers, here's my question. There are two Republican presidential candidates running from Florida. Name one of them. Good luck.
Jeb Bush.
Jeb Bush, correct. Oscar, the Fifth Amendment says, quote, nor shall private property be taken for public use without just compensation. What is the more common name for this power?
Eminent domain?
Correct. 1-1. In the Articles of Confederation, how many votes were needed to pass a law?
9.
Is it 9?
9.
Correct. Oscar, who is the only president in American history to have had the power of line item veto, albeit briefly?
Lincoln?
Incorrect, for the steal and the win.
Repeat the question.
Who is the only president in American history to have had the power of line item veto briefly?
Carter?
Bill Clinton. Christina, we go back to you for the win. What is the name of the agreement reached at the Constitutional Convention for counting slaves?
Three-fifths compromise.
Correct, for the victory. Mr. Perez and Kat, come on up. Kat, we'll start with you.
Okay.
What is the only institution created by Article 3 of the United States Constitution?
The Senate?
Incorrect.
Sorry.
Abraham, for the steal.
The judiciary.
Second?
The judiciary.
Is that close enough? Article 3. The judiciary was his answer. Is that close enough? Yes, at 1-0. Abraham, we'll go to you. I was looking for Supreme Court, but judiciary is close. Okay. Okay, can we go to picture 42 for you, Abraham? What is the name of the man pictured on the right who was the head of Al-Qaeda on the day of the 9/11 attacks?
Osama bin Laden?
Correct. Kat, we'll go to you.
Okay.
Let's quiet down, please. Thank you. Which UC campus was at the center of the controversy in the case of Bakke versus the California Board of Regents?
UC Davis.
Correct. Abraham, this goes to you for the win. What is the phrase that describes the practice of a president who takes money appropriated by Congress and reappropriates it where he, the president, wants it?
Pass.
For the steal.
I don't know.
Impoundment.
Oh, what? Sorry.
Okay, can we go to, this is for Kat?
Yeah.
Kat, this is for you.
Okay.
This is the best looking guy video 17.
Okay.
Hello, Earl Warren Cup contestants. Mr. Adams here. I'm standing here at Pearl Harbor, the site of the beginning of World War II. Here's the Arizona in the background. Here's my question to you. How many wars have been officially declared in United States history?
Five.
Correct. 2-2. Abraham, it's you for the win. If the president receives a bill that has been passed by both chambers of Congress and he neither signs nor vetoes it, what then happens to the bill? Note, he receives it in the middle of a congressional session, not in the end.
It becomes a law.
Correct, for the victory. Adrian and McKenzie, come on up. Who are we going to start with? Adrian, we'll begin with you. In which Federalist paper does Hamilton describe the judiciary as, quote, the least dangerous branch?
51.
Incorrect. For the steal.
78.
Correct. Can we please have Mr. David Duquette come on stage to ask this question?
Must a person be to become president?
At least 35.
Correct.
Adrian, we go to you. What amendment was being interpreted when the Supreme Court created the, quote, clear and present danger doctrine?
The ninth?
Incorrect. For the steal and the win.
Sorry, can you repeat it?
Sure. What amendment was being interpreted when the Supreme Court created the clear and present danger doctrine?
The four?
Incorrect. McKenzie, we go back to you. Video number 11. This is for the win.
Hi, everybody. It's Kathy Lee Gifford here from the Today Show, saying hello to everybody at Bakersfield High. You know, my husband, Frank Gifford, just loved Bakersfield, and he was so proud to have been a driller all those years ago. So here's my question. Which candidate, out of all the candidates running for president in 2016, was born in Canada? Which one was born in Canada?
Which candidate was born in Canada? I need an answer.
I don't know.
For the steal.
Jeb Bush.
Incorrect. Ted Cruz. Adrian, we go back to you. What's the score? 2-0, okay. In June 2013, the Supreme Court struck down which federal marriage law that had been on the books since 1996? I need an answer.
Pass.
For the steal and the victory.
Doma?
Correct, Doma. Sheree and Hannah, come on up. Who do we start with? Hannah, we'll start with you. Who killed Alexander Hamilton in a duel?
Aaron Burr.
Aaron Burr, correct, 1-0. Sheree. Which ancient philosopher wrote The Republic? Sure, I need an answer.
I don't know.
Hannah.
Plato.
Plato is correct, 2-0. Hannah, this is to you for the victory. What is the name of a member of the Electoral College who does not vote the same way as his or her state voted?
Faithless elector.
Correct for the victory. Madeline and Bo, come on up. Okay, we're going to start. Madeline, we'll start with you. Video 13 for you, Madeline.
Hi, everyone. I'm Matt Lauer. Here's the question. Which amendment in the Constitution was most recently incorporated by the Supreme Court in 2010?
The second.
Correct. 1-0. Bo. Which article and section of the Constitution forbids states from granting titles of nobility? Article and section.
Article 1, section 8.
Incorrect for the steal.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. Which article and section number of the Constitution forbids states from granting titles of nobility?
Article 1, section 10.
Correct. 2-0. Ms. Cooney. What is the nickname of the position that heads the Office of National Drug Control Policy?
The Drug Czar.
The Drug Czar for the victory. Bill Keeson-Brayton, come on up. Bill Keeson, we'll begin with you. Which department of government is responsible for running American embassies throughout the world? I need an answer, Bookies.
Pass.
For the steal.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. Which department of government is responsible for running American embassies throughout the world?
I do not know.
It's the State Department. Braden, let's go to video 14 for you.
Sounds good.
What's the minimum number of votes a state can have in the Electoral College?
Braden?
Two.
Incorrect for the steal. The minimum number of votes a state can have in the Electoral College?
270.
Incorrect, it's three.
It's three,
oh,
yeah. Right after.
Bill Keese, we'll go back to you. Which president ascended to the White House when William McKinley was assassinated?
Can you read the question?
Yes, which president ascended to the White House, became president, when William McKinley was assassinated?
Pass.
For the steal.
Teddy Roosevelt.
Roosevelt, correct. Braden, we'll go to you. Picture 43. Braden. This is President Frank Underwood from what fictional Netflix political drama?
House of Cards.
House of Cards. Bill Keese, we'll go to you, and we'll have. This will be for you, Bill Keese. Video 4 for Bill Keese. Video 4.
This is for the students at Bakersfield High School. The answer is, this is the first state to vote in the 2016 primaries.
The first state to vote, period.
Iowa?
Correct. Braden, 2-1, this is you for the win. When I say, quote, the president proposes and the Senate disposes, what process or power am I referring to?
Can you repeat the question?
When I say the president proposes and the Senate disposes, what process am I referring to? For the steel bill case.
Gridlock?
Incorrect. Confirmation. Bill Keys, it's 2-1. Please translate this Latin quote, e pluribus unum.
Out of many, we are one.
Correct, to all. Okay, Braden, this goes to you for the win. Roger Sherman brokered what agreement at the Constitutional Convention?
The Sherman Act?
Incorrect. Okay, Bill Keys for the win.
Repeat the question, please.
Roger Sherman brokered what agreement at the Constitutional Convention? I need an answer.
Connecticut plan?
Correct, for the victory. Nathan and Cassidy, come on up. Nathan will begin with you. Nathan, what are the first three words of the Constitution?
We the people?
Correct, 1-0. Cassidy, please look at picture 44. President Obama has taken steps towards normalization with this nation. What nation is it?
Cuba.
Correct, 1-1. Nathan, what is the name of the law in the 1960s that outlawed discrimination in public places such as hotels, motels, restaurants, etc.?
The 1964 Civil Rights Act.
Correct, 2-1. Cassidy, why wasn't Thomas Jefferson at the Constitutional Convention?
He was sick.
Incorrect for the steal, and this is the win, Mr. Rainer. And for the victory.
He was a minister to France.
Correct, for the victory. Kristen and Michael. Okay, we're going with Michael? Michael, we'll begin with you.
Sure.
I already asked. Mikey, What is always the first primary state, not necessarily the first state to vote in the presidential nomination process?
New Hampshire?
Correct, 1-0. Kristen, name one of two states that voted for recreational marijuana legalization in 2012.
Colorado.
Correct, 1-1. During the Virginia ratification debate, who was the chief spokesperson against ratification of the Constitution and Madison's opponent?
It's a tough one.
It is.
Adams?
Incorrect. For the steal.
Patterson?
Incorrect. Patrick Henry. Let's go to picture 19. No. Video 19? You mean video? Video 19. I'm sorry. Video 19.
Hi, I'm Congressman Kevin McCarthy. I've got a question for you. Which clause of the Constitution was important in the landmark decision of Plessy versus Ferguson and Brown versus the Board of Education? Now, good luck, and once a driller, always a driller.
Was it the Commerce Clause?
It's not the Commerce Clause. For the steal.
The Equal Protection Clause?
Correct. Okay, we're gonna go to video 20 for Mikey, and this is for the victory, Mikey. Michael.
Hi, I'm Congressman Kevin McCarthy. Now here's your question. Teddy Roosevelt lost the nomination for the Republican Party in 1912. What was the name of the third party he founded? Good luck.
Okay, I got this. No, just kidding. The Republican Party?
Incorrect.
Was it the Progressive Party?
Incorrect. It was the Bull Moose Party. Kristen, which Supreme Court justice famously shook his head when President Obama criticized the court for its Citizens United decision during a State of the Union?
Alito.
Alito, correct. To all. Mikey, we go to you. Monticello was the home of which founding father?
Jefferson.
Correct, 3-2. This is to stay in. How do most Americans describe their political orientation?
Can you repeat the question?
Yes, how do most Americans describe their political orientation?
Like,
I need an answer.
By their family?
Incorrect, it's moderate or independent. Okay. Mikey wins. Cameron and Maddie, come on up. Maddie, we'll begin with you. Maddie, what is the name of the process whereby each state is allotted a certain number of congressional seats?
Pass.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes, what is the name of the process whereby each state is allotted a certain number of congressional seats? I need an answer.
I'll pass.
Reapportionment.
Those districts.
Cameron, we'll go to you. What is the name of the NBC drama from the early 2000s that followed the presidency of President Josiah Bartlett and is my favorite show of all time besides Hannah Montana?
West Wing.
Correct. Maddie, we go to you. What is the term that describes a Supreme Court decision that is unsigned?
Per curiam.
Correct. Picture number 45. Cameron, this goes for you.
Thanks.
You're welcome. This is the logo of whose presidential campaign?
Oh, God.
Is it Hillary Clinton?
Correct. Maddie, we go to you. Which Reagan-appointed justice on the Supreme Court describes himself as a, quote, originalist?
Scalia.
Correct. To all. Cameron, this is to you for the win, since she started. What is the name of the statement the president gives to Congress every January as mandated by the Constitution?
State of the Union.
Correct for the victory. Is there a representative from Jim Burke Ford here this evening? Come on up. Jacob and Tim, here we go.
Well, which Supreme Court justice once worked for the ACLU?
Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
Correct.
Correct. Mr. Rossi.
Yes, sir.
Who was Washington's first Secretary of State?
Thomas Jefferson.
Correct. 1-1. Jacob, this is for you, and this is video. We've already done 4. Almost half of the words in the Constitution appear in which article?
Article 1.
Correct. 2-1. Okay. Can we please go to, this will be for you, Tim, video 22. Video 22.
Good evening, Bakersfield High. My name is Blake Keekley. I'm a 2008 graduate of Bakersfield High. 2007, I participated in the Earl Warren Cup and got third place. I'm here tonight representing Keekley, Maxwell, and Anton Giovanni, one of the event sponsors for tonight. In 2007, while in Mr. Adams' class, I incorrectly predicted that Rudy Giuliani would not only be the Republican nominee for president, but that he would eventually go on to win the presidency as well. My question for you is, before he was a failed presidential candidate, what city was he the mayor of? Good luck.
Rudy Giuliani, what city was he mayor of?
New York.
Correct, 2-2. Jacob, this is not for the victory, because we started with you. In the court case of Brandenburg versus Ohio, what organization was Brandenburg a member of?
The KKK.
Correct, 3-2. Tim, this is for you to stay in. Lee Harvey Oswald shot which U.S. president?
John F. Kennedy.
Correct, three all. Mr. Lee, who famously said, give me liberty or give me death?
Thomas Paine.
Incorrect, for the steal and the victory.
Patrick Henry.
For the win. Christina and Abraham, come on up. Christina and Abraham. Okay, who to start with? Okay, Ms. McKenna, we'll start with you. Who said, quote, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country?
Washington.
Incorrect, for the steal.
JFK.
Correct, 1-0. Abraham, please look at picture number 47. In what American city is the Gateway Arch located?
St. Louis.
Correct, 2-0. Who is considered to be the father of the country?
Washington.
Correct, 2-1. Abraham, this is yours for the victory. Okay. How many votes are needed to pass a law if it is being filibustered?
60.
Correct, for the victory. Mackenzie and Hannah, come on up. Okay. Hannah, we'll begin with you. Video 16 for Hannah Chang.
Hello, Bakersfield High School. I'm Doug Elmendorf, the Dean of the Harvard Kennedy School of Government and formerly the Director of the Congressional Budget Office. Here's your question. What office in the Executive Office of the President is responsible for writing the federal budget? Good luck.
The Office of Budgetary Management.
Incorrect.
The OMB.
What does that stand for?
Office of Management and Budget.
Correct, Office of Management. Mackenzie, we'll go to you. Who is the only person in American history to be a First Lady and a U.S. Senator? I need an answer.
I don't know.
Hannah, for the steal.
Hillary Clinton.
Hillary Clinton.
Well, I knew that. Yeah, I did.
Hannah, we go to you. If Maine has two congressional districts, how many electoral votes does it have?
You said it has two congressional.
If it has two congressional districts, how many votes does it have?
Four.
Four, correct. Mackenzie, please look at picture 46 or 47?
46.
Picture 46. The person in this picture once said, the conservation of our natural resources and their proper use constitute the fundamental problem which underlies almost every other problem of our national life. Who is this?
Teddy Roosevelt.
Correct. To all. Okay. Hand it to you, but not for the victory, because we start with you. What is the name of the network that airs congressional debates and committee hearings? Please do not yell out answers, folks.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. What is the name of the network that airs congressional debates and committee hearings?
NBC.
Incorrect, for the steal and the victory?
I'm going to have pass.
C-SPAN. Mackenzie, this goes to you for the victory. Which justice argued during his confirmation hearing that judges are like umpires of the political process?
Roberts.
Correct, for the victory. Madeline and Bill Keys, come up for the final eight. Just... Ms. Cooney, we'll go to you. What is the food metaphor used by many political scientists to describe a system of government in which the powers of the state and national government are intermixed?
Layer cake or marble cake?
Correct. Okay, Bill Keese, we'll go to you. Video number 6 for Bill Keese. This goes to you.
Hello, Bakersfield High School. My name is Tony Blair. I'm a former British Prime Minister, and I'd like to pose this question to you. Which British Prime Minister was the child of an American citizen and was an honorary American citizen himself?
Pass.
For the steal.
I don't know.
Winston Churchill. We'll go to you. Which 19th century Supreme Court case dealt with the practice of bigamy as it relates to the free exercise clause?
Reynolds v. U.S.
Say again?
Reynolds v. U.S.
Correct. Bill Keese, we go to you. Who was the candidate in 2004 who, after placing third in Iowa, gave a boisterous speech that ended with a famous scream?
I don't know.
For the steal and the victory.
Dean Howard. Howard Dean, sorry.
Howard Dean, correct.
Sorry.
Okay. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, sorry, yeah. Nathan and Michael, come on up.
Nathan, I love you.
Nathan, we'll start with you. Please go to picture 48. 48? Okay. These are Barack Obama's two daughters who seem as impressed with their father as my children seem with me at times. Name one of them.
Sasha or Malia.
Or both. Good. 1-0. Michael, in 1975, Schoolhouse Rock came out with a song describing the lawmaking process. What is the name of this song?
Do you mind if I sing it?
Give me the answer and keep it short.
All right, I'll keep it a little short. I'm just a bill.
Correct.
Yes, I'm only a bill.
Nathan, we'll go to you. And this will be video 15 for Nathan. Video 15.
Hi, I'm Melissa Morris, 2007 winner of the Earl Warren Cup. I've been living in Seattle the past 3 years working for Amazon. And here's your question. What current Republican candidate caused controversy a few months back when discussing the citizenship clause of the 14th Amendment?
It kind of sounds, wait, what did she say?
Which Republican candidate caused controversy by questioning the citizenship clause of the 14th Amendment? I need an answer.
It sounds like something Trump would do.
What's your answer, Nathan?
Donald Trump.
Correct. Michael, this is for you. Which president presided over a series of programs called the New Deal?
FDR.
Correct. To all. Nathan. What is the name of the political party founded by Jefferson and Madison?
The Democratic Republicans?
Correct, 3-2. Michael, this is for you to stay in it. Okay. Please look at picture number 49. Michael, this is the same person in both pictures. Who is it?
Hillary Clinton?
Incorrect.
Sorry.
Oh, I know it too.
Sorry.
Dang it.
That was it.
I know.
It was Chelsea Clinton. Okay. Good job. Cameron and Tim, come on up. Go BHS baseball.
BHS baseball. BHS baseball right here.
We actually are smart.
Cameron Johnson 09.
Well,
Tim, we'll start with you. In a 1942 Supreme Court case, a man named Chaplinsky was arrested for disturbing the peace, and the court said that his, quote, fighting words were not protected free speech. In what state did this occur?
New Hampshire.
Correct, 1-0. Cameron, please watch video number 10. Video number 10 for Cameron.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Minnesota. I'm Kaylin Macaranis, and I'm the 2013 winner of the Earl Warren Cup. Winning was one of the most surrealist moments of my life, and I remember it just like it was yesterday. Right now, I'm in the process of transferring to the University of Minnesota, Twin Cities, and currently work part-time at Sea Life Aquarium. I wish all of you guys the best of luck, and my question for you guys is, President Obama went to Harvard, Columbia, and Occidental universities, but what state was he born in?
He was born in Hawaii.
Correct. Tim, we go to you. What politician famously said in a debate, I am not going to make age an issue in this campaign. I will not exploit for political purposes my opponent's youth and inexperience.
That'd be Ronald Reagan.
Correct, 2-1. Cameron, who was the first president to aggressively use the veto to insert the president into the lawmaking process?
Andrew Jackson.
Correct, 2-all. Tim, which English Enlightenment philosopher wrote the Second Treatise of Civil Government?
Thomas Paine.
Incorrect for the steal and the win, Cameron.
Is it Locke?
It is Locke. Abraham McKenzie, come on up. McKenzie, we'll begin with you. You feel the tension? Feel the tension?
Feel it.
Okay, McKenzie, just a little bit. Here we go. What is the name of the official in the Justice Department who argues all cases on behalf of the government in front of the Supreme Court?
The Speaker?
Incorrect. For the steal, Abraham.
Can you repeat the question?
What is the name of the official in the Justice Department who argues all cases on behalf of the government in front of the Supreme Court?
The Solicitor General?
Correct. 1-0. Abraham, please look at picture number 50. Picture number 50. This man is considered to be the king of talk radio. Who is this?
Pass?
Pass.
Nope, not gonna know. Okay.
Mr. Benetti? Rush Limbaugh.
Oh my God.
McKenzie, we'll go to you. Which president presided over the building of the Panama Canal? I need an answer.
FDR.
Incorrect. For the steal.
Panama Canal, right?
Yes. Which president presided over the building of it?
Teddy Roosevelt?
Correct. 2-0. We go to you, Abraham. Which amendment is the following quote taken from? Quote, the 18th Amendment to the Constitution of the United States is hereby repealed.
21st.
Correct, for the victory. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your semifinalists. We will now be asking from a different and harder set of questions, and it's now the first one to 4, not 3. Can we? Maddie and Nathan, come on up. Can we please begin with video number 21 for Maddie?
Hello,
My name is Peter Westmacott, and I'm the British ambassador to the United States. And here's my question for you. Which British sailor, when he was circumnavigating the globe, claimed much of the west coast of the United States of America for Queen Elizabeth I of England in 1579?
Sir Francis Drake.
Correct, 1-0. Nathan, in what city will the 2016 Republican Convention be held?
Cincinnati.
Incorrect. For the steal, Madeline.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. In what city will the 2016 Republican Convention be held?
Philadelphia.
Incorrect. Cleveland.
I got the C right.
Maddie, we go back to you. Who occupied Kevin McCarthy's congressional seat for almost 30 years before retiring in 2006? I need an answer.
John Boehner.
Incorrect. Yes. For the steal.
So the our representative before McCarthy?
Yes.
Was Bill Thomas?
Correct. Okay. Please look at question, slide 32, please. Nathan, take a look at it. This picture is from the most famous of Martin Luther King's speeches, but what is the name of the essay he wrote when he was once arrested in Birmingham, Alabama?
A letter from Birmingham jail?
Correct, 2-1. Maddie, we'll go to you. Which amendment deals with the issue of congressional salaries?
The 20th.
Incorrect. For the steal, Nathan.
27th.
Correct. Nathan, this goes to you for the win. The term advising consent is found in which article and section number of the Constitution?
Shh. Sorry, that was impolite. I believe it's Article 1, Section 3.
Incorrect. For the steal.
Article 2, Section 2.
Correct. Maddie, start to you, with you. Which 20th century president was the subject of a recent biography by John Meacham entitled Destiny and Power, The American Odyssey of?
Lyndon B. Johnson.
Incorrect. For the steal and the win.
What was the name of the book? I mean, sorry, the first part.
The name of the book is, which 20th century president had a book written about them entitled, quote, Destiny and Power, The American Odyssey of?
Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
George H.W. Bush.
That could work.
But Nathan, this is to you for the win. Which president attempted to evoke executive privilege to prevent Secret Service officers from testifying in an investigation?
William Clinton.
Correct for the victory. Cameron and Abraham, come on up. Abraham, we'll begin with you. According to the 20th Amendment, the president becomes president at noon on what day of the year?
November 6th?
Incorrect.
Is it February 2nd?
Incorrect. It's January 20th.
Oh.
Cameron, we go to you. John Hinckley Jr. attempted an assassination of which U.S. president?
Ronald Reagan.
Correct. Can we please get to picture 34 for Abraham? This is a picture of Neil Armstrong on the moon in 1969, but who famously asked or said, we will go to the moon and do the other things not because they are easy, but because they are hard?
John F. Kennedy.
Correct. Cameron, it's 1-1. Which amendment protects from the quartering of troops in the home?
The 7th Amendment.
Incorrect. For the steal?
Third.
Third is correct. Abraham, which justice wrote these words last year in a decision regarding same-sex marriage? Quote, "No union is more profound than marriage, for it embodies the highest ideals of love, fidelity, devotion, sacrifice, and family. The Constitution grants them that right." Which justice wrote that?
John Roberts?
Incorrect. For the steal.
Is it Kagan?
Incorrect. It is Kennedy.
He's the swing
vote. Cameron, we go to you. Which landmark law ceded all unsettled lands to the federal government and established a method for admitting new states into the Union?
Can you repeat the question?
Which law ceded all unsettled states to the federal government and established a method for admitting new states into the Union? I need an answer.
It's probably wrong, but the Missouri Compromise.
Incorrect. For the steal.
Can you repeat the question?
Which law ceded all federal lands to the federal government and established a method for admitting new states to the Union? I need an answer.
I don't know.
Northwest Ordinance. Abraham, we'll go to you.
Okay.
Which Supreme Court justice equated the Lemon versus Kurtzman decision as a, quote, ghoul in a late night film that haunts our Establishment Clause jurisprudence?
Scalise? No.
Is that close enough?
No.
Cameron? Because it was close, we'll do
same question?
Sorry, yes. Same question.
Scalia?
I gave it away there by asking, telling you it was close, though. I did, so I need to
ask. Mr. Adams.
I did, sorry. I said I was going to make a mistake.
Come on.
Okay, Cameron. You'll forgive me, you'll forgive me.
Is this a new question?
It's a new question.
You stole me ice cream.
Yeah, okay, so he doesn't get to steal this one. Okay. Huh? Oh, no, he does. This is still a steal.
This is a regular question.
Yes.
What's the score?
This is a steal. What's the score? 2-1 Abraham, and this is for a steal.
Oh, okay. A steal.
This is for a steal, because I screwed
up. So I get a new question after this?
Yes.
Okay.
What is the name of the group of House Republicans that describe themselves as a, quote, smaller, more cohesive, more agile, and more active group of conservatives?
That's in the House?
Yes.
I don't know, Tea Party? I don't know.
Incorrect. It was the Freedom Caucus. Yeah, this goes back to you.
Yay.
Yeah. What position was William Marbury seeking through his appointment from John Adams?
Oh, gosh.
I don't know, something in D.C., like a judge or something, right?
Secretary of State?
Is incorrect. It was Justice of the Peace.
God.
Abraham, we go
I'm
to
like
you.
I'm like there, man.
Originally, how many justices were there on the Supreme Court?
6?
Correct. 3-1.
So this is to stay in it?
No. This is not to stay in it. It's 3-1.
It's 3-1. Yeah, because you go to 4.
Oh, we go to 4.
Okay. Picture 31. Cameron.
That flow.
That's picture 31. Picture 31. We no.
Thanks, Fletcher.
Okay, Cameron. Which river is Washington floating on in this picture?
The Delaware.
Correct. Okay. So it's 3-2. Abraham, this is to you for the win. Virtually everyone uses the phrase ISIS to describe the Islamic State headed by Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. President Obama uses a different term. What is it?
I don't know.
I need an answer for the steal.
It's ISIL.
Correct. Cameron, this is to you for the win.
Okay.
For the win.
Guys.
Thanks, Cameron. Thanks.
I mean,
I love
him, but...
Which Pennsylvania delegate wrote the elastic clause into the Constitution?
John Williams?
Incorrect for the steal and the win.
James Wilson.
Correct for the victory. Can we please give it up for Madeline Cooney and Cameron Johnson, our third place winners tonight? Good job. Come back up and move on. Come back up and move on. Just stay, there. Folks, it's time to crown a winner. Get on up here. Abraham and Nathan. Come on up. Let's go. Nathan, we'll begin with you. Nathan, here we go. Let's quiet down, please. According to John Boehner, whose trip to the United States was a factor in his decision to step down as Speaker of the House?
Pope Francis.
Correct. 1-0. Abraham, which Enlightenment philosopher wrote the book Spirit of the Laws?
Pass.
For the steal.
I want to say Montesquieu.
Correct. 2-0. Nathan, we go back to you. Who was the first U.S. Civil Service Commissioner in the 1880s?
Was that Teddy Roosevelt?
Correct. 3-0. Abraham, which famous historian coined the phrase the imperial presidency?
I don't know.
For the steal and the championship.
Arthur Schlesinger Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2016 champion, Nathan Solan!
Yeah. Yeah.